I want you just to draw a number line. And that's all I'm going to tell you. I'm not going to give you any directions of what it's supposed to look like. I want to see what you think a number line looks like, okay? All of us have an idea of what a number line looks like. So this beginning activity provides us with the opportunity to introduce the students to what the number line in Pearl Diver is going to look like. When we get an idea of what they know, then we can move forward and teach them something new. The cool thing about this activity is that every single person in this room, believe it or not, has a different number line. All right, how many of you had a number line that started with a zero? Raise your hand. Negative numbers on it. Fractions in it. Decimals on it. So those of you that chose to put fractions on your number line, this reminds me very much of the number rights video that we watched yesterday. Remember the number rights video we watched yesterday? So she was advocating for having what, fractions and negative numbers. And so a lot of you put that on your number line. So that's really, really great to see. There's some stacks on your tables. I need all of you to get an iPad. Go ahead and put your number lines to the side. We'll use those again in a while. I'll give you this one. There's a game on there. So if you look up here on the board, the game that you're going to click on is called Pearl Diver. And I actually want you to have the volume on. The only other rule I have for the game is that I want you to talk and I want you to help your neighbor. Can you do that?
Yeah.
So if you get stuck, you can either ask me or you can ask your neighbor or someone behind you. It doesn't matter. All right?
Because I am going to use that.
The whole numbers are longer, so it's kind of like the same way you did it here, right? All right, I need for you to mute your iPad. I want you to turn it over in front of you. So what do you think about this game? After playing the game for about 10 to 15 minutes, it's really important to stop and have the kids discuss. This gives you the opportunity to share strategies or for them to recognize the difference between their initial drawing and the number line they're seeing in the game. What kind of strategies are you using that you want to share, like to do things a little bit faster? Joy?
Try to go fast before the time runs out.
Try to go fast. Okay, does anyone have, I saw Moy doing something very interesting to go faster. What was it?
I was double tapping on the pearls.
He was double tapping, so I had never really seen that before, but at the bottom he was going like that, like double tapping. Any other hints for getting things done faster? Stay away from the eel, you can double click. Okay, Bella?
The number line, it changes like by, at first it's 0 to 10.
0, and it went all the way to 10. And the second one, what did it look like?
The second one was -5 to 5.
-5 to 5. And then what?
And then there was like decimals, fractions.
Did some of them even start with fractions? Or end with fractions? Okay, so what kind of fractions did you guys see? Are there any clues about the number line itself that you can use when you're looking for fractions and decimals?
The longer lines are the whole numbers.
The longer or the taller lines are the whole numbers. Did everybody notice that before? What's another way that I could write 1/2?
You can use 0.5.
0.5, 0.5. What's another way I can say 0.5?
4/8.
4/8. Did we have that in the game?
Yes.
Was there 4/8? Really? Wow. Okay. So 4/8 was another equivalent way to say 1/2. Okay. We're gonna go ahead and play the game for another 15 minutes, and then we're gonna do a hands-on activity. So go ahead and open your iPads. Turn the music on. If you didn't notice before, the little hints as far as like the height of the lines, try to use those to get through later levels. Yeah, keep track of your high scores because I'm going to ask you what they are. So, all right, so what are some of the high scores that you got? We're not collecting the scores to compare one student to another. We're collecting the scores because they're data points, and then we can use them to build an additional number line. Okay, so we had the smallest number was 4,445, and the biggest number was 15,700. What would be the best scale to use for my number line? Let's see, right here.
Hundreds.
A thousand?
You can go up by 2,000s.
I could go up by 2,000s, and I could go from 4,000 to 6, to 8, to 10, to 12, to 14. That might even make more sense. So the scale that you use depends, right, on the numbers that you have. Obviously, the primary objective of Pearl Diver is the number line. However, it's really important not to forget the sushi round. It gives you the opportunity as a teacher to talk about estimation, especially when you're dealing with fractions. Okay, so I'm gonna do it right here. Right there? Does everybody agree?
No.
Yes.
No?
No.
A little bit this way or a little bit that way?
Right in the middle.
So right there?
Of that, yeah.
Okay, right there. And what about the second cut? Right about there? Everybody agree with that?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what happens.
A little off,
but that was pretty good. We're pretty close. And then if I have thirds and I want to divide it into sixths, I can just cut each of these pieces in half. Everybody understand that part? In their small groups, I give them cards with different kinds of numbers. We have positive, negative, fractions, improper fractions, decimals, whole numbers, and they have to put them in order from smallest to largest. Then we take all of those numbers as a whole class and put them on a big number line to work with. So are we in the right order now? Okay, so if we were gonna draw this number line on the board, what would be the best number to start with? We have halves, we have quarters, we have lots of different things to worry about. Okay, do we want to try this again with a different set of numbers?
Yes.
All right, let's go ahead and go back to your seats. And I'm just going to hand you a stack of cards and have you guys put them in order like this.
Pearl Diver is a great way to talk about number sense and things that students struggle with, including equivalence, the idea of improper fractions, and how all of the numbers are related to each other.
So how is this related to Pearl Diver?
In Pearl Diver, you need to find, it tells you which place you need to go on the number line, and you need to go there, and you need to get the pearl from there.
So how is that different than what we did here? What did we take these numbers? What did we do with them?
We organized them. Instead of trying to find them, we were putting them into order.
Right. And then we would build a number line afterwards, right? What are some things that you have to keep in mind when you're building a number line?
Maybe between the whole numbers, you want to space them evenly.
Perfect. Try and put at least four or five of the numbers in front of you on your very own number line that you started with. List or talk about some of the math words that you heard while you were playing Pearl Diver or when we were having our discussions. Have one partner write them down. Each group, try and come up with at least five.
Instead of identifying the math vocabulary and providing the definitions for the students, it's always a lot more interesting to have them experience the concept and then they are able to pick out what the important math vocabulary is.
I'm gonna go from one pair to the next and you have to give me something different or something that's not already listed on the board. Does that make sense? Okay, which one? No, just one.
Equivalent.
Equivalent, all right, so equivalent.
Negative.
Reduce.
Decimal.
Fraction.
Positive.
Estimating.
Estimating! Perfect!
Of course playing the game is fun. It always is. But don't discount the activity and the reflection. That gives the students the opportunity to see what they learned for that day, and that also provides them a huge amount of satisfaction.